here's how to make a background transparent in Photoshop. In this video, we're going to learn how to make a selection, remove a selection, and save an image with a transparent background. Let's get started. There are many ways to make selections in Photoshop. We'll be covering three of the most common methods: the Magic Wand tool, the Quick Selection tool, and the Pen tool. The Magic Wand tool works great with simple shapes and backgrounds. First, open your image in Photoshop. Then we're going to duplicate the layer. This keeps a non-destructive version of the image available for reference. In the layer panel, left-click and drag your background image down to the Create a New Layer icon. Now, click the layer visibility icon for the background layer. This will make the background layer hidden. Now let's locate the Magic Wand tool in the Tools panel on the left side. Depending on what workspace you're in, the organization of the tools may look different. We are using the Essentials workspace, which is the Photoshop default. The fourth tool down is where the Magic Wand is located. To find it, you may need to right-click to expand this tool submenu, then select Magic Wand. Now, make sure you've selected your visible layer. Then use the Magic Wand and click the background you want to remove. If your selection did not grab the full background, go to the top and use the tolerance setting to refine the tool's selection abilities. This number will range depending on your image. For this example, a tolerance of 45 worked best. Start with a lower tolerance number and work up by using the tool, unselecting using Command D, adjusting tolerance, and then using the tool again. Repeat this until the background is fully selected like this. Once the tolerance is set accordingly, you can add additional selections as needed. For this example, there's some of the background in the top right corner that has not been selected by the Magic Wand. In the Magic Wand tool menu at the top, click Add to Selection. Zoom in and click the additional areas of the background that need to be removed. Now at the top, go to the Select drop-down menu. Go down and click Select and Mask. This will open the Select and Mask workspace. A checkered background is transparent and is what's being removed or masked by your selection. If your background is showing and the object is missing, go to the right menu and click Invert. Under the Global Refinements menu, you can make adjustments to your selection. For this example, let's remove the blue edge still showing on the flowers. Adjust Shift Edge and Feather as needed to make a clean edge. Go down to Output Settings. Make sure Output 2 has Layer Mask selected and click OK. The Quick Selection tool works best with objects or backgrounds that are a little more complex. Let's remove the sky in this landscape photo. First, duplicate the layer. This keeps a non-destructive version of the image available for reference. In the Layers panel, left-click and drag your background image down to the Create a New Layer icon. Now, click the Layer Visibility icon for the background layer. This will make the background layer hidden. Now let's locate the Quick Selection tool in the Tools panel on the left side. Depending on what workspace you're in, the organization of the tools may look different. We are using the Essentials workspace, which is Photoshop's default. The fourth tool down is where the Quick Selection tool is located. To find it, you may need to right-click to expand this tool submenu, then select Quick Selection Tool. Adjust your Quick Selection brush size to something smaller than your background, but not too large. Use the left and right bracket keys to adjust size or the pull-down menu at the top. Make sure you have selected your visible layer and start selecting parts of your background until the background is fully selected. If the selection has expanded beyond the background, we will refine that now. To add or remove some of the selection, use the tools at the top labeled Add to Selection and Subtract from Selection. In our example, the selection has expanded into some of the peaks of the mountains. Let's use the Subtract from Selection tool. Again, use your bracket keys or the drop-down menu to adjust the selection tool size. Here we want a brush size smaller than the size of the selection area we are removing. Now click in the area where you want to remove the selection that has expanded past the background. Repeat this with any discrepancies with the entire selection. go to the Select drop-down menu and click Select and Mask. This will open up the Select and Mask workspace. A checkered background is transparent and is what's being removed or masked by your selection. If your background is showing and the object is missing, go to the right menu and click Invert. Here you can make adjustments to your selection to refine it. Adding a slight feather is always a good starting point and will help with making your image more seamless with any background you put behind it. Go down to Output Settings and make sure Output 2 has Layer Mask selected and click OK. The Pen tool is used to make a controlled and detailed cutout. This tool requires a little bit more time to use over the Magic Wand or the Quick Selection tool, but it can give you the best results. Let's remove a single holiday cookie from this image. First, open your image in Photoshop. Then we're going to duplicate the layer. This keeps a non-destructive version of the image available for reference. In the Layers panel, left-click and drag your background image down to the Create a New Layer icon. Now click the Layer Visibility icon for the background layer. This will make the background layer hidden. Now let's locate the Pen tool in the Tools panel on the left side. Depending on what workspace you're in, the organization of the tools may look different. We are using the Essentials workspace, which is Photoshop's default. The Pen tool is easy to find. It looks like a pen. Let's zoom in on a single cookie and begin using the Pen tool. With the Pen tool, we're going to make an outline of the object we're trying to select. Click on your image and make your first point to start making your selection. I'm going to start at a corner of the cookie. Now you're going to begin working your way around the object. I'm going to go to the right. You want to make a second point on the same curve, not multiple curves later. Click and hold on your next point. Drag to create the curve and line it up with what you're cutting out, then unclick. Repeat this for the next point on the cutout. Now, if your next point's curve is a little off, hold down Option and click on the curve adjustment points to adjust the curve like this. You can also hold down Command to move the cutout point if it is slightly off, or if you're unable to make the curve correct. Repeat these steps all the way around the object until you make it back to your first cutout point. Click on the final cutout point to complete the cutout. On the right, go to your Layers panel. Make sure you have selected your visible layer and click on the Work Path tab. Inside the Work Path box, hold down Command and click. This has created a selection around the pen path drawn earlier. Now that the object is selected, go to the Select drop-down menu and click Select and Mask. This will open up the Select and Mask workspace. Here you can make adjustments to your selection to refine it. Adding a slight feather is always a good starting point and will help with making your image more seamless with any background you put behind it. Go down to Output Settings, make sure Output 2 has Layer Mask selected and click OK. Your background is now removed and you can save this as a PNG file type, which keeps the background transparent and saves a cutout version of the image. To export, open the File drop-down menu and go to Export. Then select Export As. Change format to PNG. Here you can also change your image size and then click Export. Name your file and save. Your image is now saved as a cutout with a transparent background and ready for any background you want to put behind it.